September 11th, 2017. Flying 480 miles above New Mexico, an Earth observation satellite photographs a series of strange circles in the desert.
You can't help but wonder, what is this gigantic bullseye doing in the middle of the desert?
It really looks like a giant dartboard, but the question is, what game are they playing here?
Aerospace journalist Joe Pappalardo dials down the magnification on the satellite image to analyze the surrounding terrain.
When you look at where this weird structure is located, clues start to emerge.
There's the fence line, there's some of the military stuff, here's some radar.
It's on the grounds of Kirtland Air Force Base.
Intelligence experts reveal that since World War II, Kirtland has played a key role in developing and testing a series of revolutionary bombers, including the B-36 Peacemaker and the F-80 Shooting Star.
This thing looks like a target. It's very possible that it could be some sort of area where bombing practices take place.
Ex-CIA operative Mike Baker disagrees.
That's probably not likely. There are no indications of any past use. You know, there's no cratering.
Military historian Martin Morgan uncovers more possible evidence about the origin of the mystery bullseye.
Kirtland Air Force Base is known for being home to the school for the pararescue jumpers, special operators who are parachute qualified and among the most elite in the American military.
Pararescue men, or PJs, are combat medics dedicated to rescuing and treating fallen comrades. Part warrior, part savior, 100% badass.
The reason the pararescue teams are so elite is that they're more often than not behind enemy lines.
They come in to a very dangerous situation, recover a pilot, recover classified information, and get the hell out.
The PJ selection process is one of the toughest in the military. It begins with 9 weeks of brutal tests of skill and endurance, culminating in a 20-hour-long ordeal known as Hell Night. 80% of potential recruits fail.
Training for the PJs is an extremely grueling process. It's everything from scuba diving to climbing mountains to parachuting in on targets.
These guys are the best of the best that the Air Force has to provide.
But Baker is unconvinced that the wide circles are an aerial target for a precision parachute troop.
When they're dropping people, they're more inclined to say, okay, you're gonna land on this mountainside, you know, 2 meters to the left of that, you know, big fir tree or whatever. I mean, it's very technical and it's very precise.
Military journalist Carlo Munoz returns to the satellite image to hunt for further clues. 6 miles northwest of the bullseye, he spots something.
There's this large white structure with a long gangplank running up to it. There's definitely some kind of military application for it.
Declassified U.S. military records reveal that during the 1970s, the giant structure played a key role in the development and testing of electromagnetic pulse weapons, or EMPs.
EMP weapons are designed to basically take out anything with an electronic circuit. It essentially fries any kind of circuit within a certain radius.
The structure is called the Atlas I Weapons Testing Platform, codename Trestle. The $60 million construction is 1,300 feet long and 120 feet high.
It's made of wood and glue. You can't have metal parts to it because it would interfere with the testing. So you'd park a plane on this structure, you'd fire an electromagnetic pulse at it, and then the scientists would basically record the results.
Military analysts speculate that the circles were designed to measure the radiating pulse of a top-secret EMP weapon.
It can disable weapons, it can ground helicopters and fighter jets. It's safe to say that that is probably part of the American arsenal.
The idea that electromagnetic pulse testing is being done at Kirtland makes complete and total sense.
The Atlas I project was abandoned in 1990. But rumors persist the Department of Defense is developing an EMP weapon with the power to cripple the electronics of an entire city.
People like to think that it's a peaceful world out there. That's not how it works, right? So as much as we'd like to think that if we haven't gamed out all the potential scenarios for conflict, that somehow if we don't do it, then other people won't do it either. And that's just crap.
The purpose of the New Mexico Bullseye remains a mystery. Coming up, hell from on high in the jungles of Southeast Asia.
It causes extreme birth defects, and not just for your immediate children, 3-4 generations down the line.